Hawaii Pacific University's plans for redeveloping Aloha Tower Marketplace are on hold for at least another week. This as its development partner is trying to maintain control of the project. Kanoe Gibson joins us with more.
Kathy, HPU is attempting to take over ownership from its development partner. The developer's attorney now says they've been defrauded.
In December of 2011, Hawaii Lifestyle Retail Properties was given the authority to provide a makeover of Aloha Tower Marketplace by the Aloha Tower Development Corporation. Now its financing partner, Hawaii Pacific University, who owns 80% of the property, is seeking complete ownership of the project. They say their plans for development are relatively the same.
At the end of the day, we would hope that the mixed-use development that we would envision would be very appealing to families, very appealing to people who want to enjoy that great waterfront area down there, but in an environment that's healthy for our students.
But the developer's attorney says they've been defrauded.
It appears to us now that HPU never intended to allow him to be a manager or a partner, and they promised to put up funds to be a partner. They never intended to put up any money.
HPU recently proposed to meet their financial obligations with tax-free bonds, which requires 100% ownership of the project. Some worry that if that happens, Aloha Tower will only benefit the students and not the local community. Future business owner Carl Strobel worries that the millions he invested in his future sports bar will go to waste.
They would pretty much leave me out.
But HPU says they are embracing both current and potential businesses.
Anyone who has an interest in a business there, we're very interested in speaking with them.
It looks to me like HPU just wants to make this a satellite campus. They need more room, they need space for their students, and we've filed for arbitration alleging fraud.
As requested by the developer's attorney, the state deferred action for another week. They will reconvene the week of January 14th. Kanoe Gibson, KHON2 News, Hawaii's News Leader.